lane gets super volatile, that can definitely be an area that Vitality and Skeens look to attack.
Melita getting his LeBlanc. Hasn't played it that much in the LEC, but was very well known for it when he was in the regional league. So I have had a quick look. We've got 10 games, 60% win rate on that champ. So that mid lane matchup has to be explosive. It has to be where our eyes go in the early game. Expectations are top's a bit of a farm fest. The jungle intervention is really where we're going to see either. You said mid lane could be explosive. Neither of them has died. There's a slight CS lead for VTO. Has got the ignite into teleport in that matchup here. It's going to be forced away here by Shigenda.
Wow, and you actually look at the minimap right now. Vander has made his way all the way up through the river from bot lane. Obviously, they saw Skeen starting off the Rift Herald, and they didn't want to have anything to do with that. So now, so deadly. They're insane divers, right? Sion, Hecarim, Rell, how do you get away from that? Then there's also the Kai'Sa to come in there, and the super long range of a Zoe, too. It is very difficult for...
Picks up a heal. And should be fine for the moment.
Yeah, we saw a couple of important interactions there that may come become very influential later on into the game. For the time being, though, Misfits are flying on in there.
There's no real way for Skeens to get away from this one. First blood to VTO, and that Zoe is popping.
Yeah, Skeens used his flash to set up a potential dive setup off the back of this Rift Herald going down. You can see the mid laner from Vitality also moving in the right direction. The question is, are they willing to commit to this? There's no TPs from Misfits. It's a 4v2. You're also diving into a Rell, which is not the easiest thing in the world.
Lebov's going to get the knock-up there onto Vander. Vander tries to flash away. Razzle and VTO coming in from the side, but the feathers fly, and Crownshot gets his first kill. Cobby's going to have to flash away as well with the TP coming in for Vitality. Misfits do not want to take this fight.
Yeah, and we're seeing the big value out of Vitality's first pick, Gnar, in a way here, because Shigenda, I think that was his first TP of the game. We might have missed down. Neither top laner has TP or will have teleport by the time this Drake does spawn. So it's important to note that Shigenda does have priority in topside. If Misfits want to fight over this Drake, it is likely here it needs to reset, sack his tower, and then make his way down, because otherwise Shigenda is going to be able to push out that top wave and then make that long trek down towards bot river.
Skeens' flash just came back off cooldown, but he's already caught in the Magna Storm, and he's already down. Can't flash if you're dead. LeBrov next on the menu as the feathers pull back through VTO, but Misfits get the kill.
Oh,
they were looking for VTO. Oh, jumps forward.
What?
Just about survives. Was that a pot? Was that a triumph? I do not quite know, but VTO should have died and somehow got out alive.
What on earth is running down through that top river, has his ultimate ready to go and ready to kick off a team fight.
And Sion can be devastating in these fights. Shigenda goes into a raged form, gets the wallop, has the Narve available. Vander, no flash to go in, no Magnet Storm, but now he's going to dive forward. The Paddle Star onto Shigenda, does quite a lot of work. Flash forward, Decimating Smash, Nard back. LeBrov looking for the flank position himself. He's going to knock Razzle back into the fight, and already here it's dead, and Cobby and VTO did not have an opportunity to attack.
That was just a 4v5, too. Melita was in the bot side pushing out waves. That's why Misfits thought they could fight, but Skeens never used his ultimate in the previous engagement. Misfits had absolutely nothing to work with outside of Hirit in that play. So Vander just instantly got popped. The layering CC from Vitality was just a little bit too good. And that has secured Vitality really silent on the Rift. Here you'll notice, though, VTO has gone for a second item QSS. This is absolutely something you need against the Skarner.
Oh, here we go.
As the Zoe
Razzle's
here.
Going in. Couldn't get close enough. The Attract Repel is going to land the stun. Onslaught of Shadows doing a huge amount of work. There's a Gnar into the wall. Suppression lands on to Vander, and he's dead. Razzle trying to run off towards the top side. But Misfits are still advancing. Misfits are still pushing in. LeBrov misses the Flash Pulverize combo, but still they have caught out Hirit. And Vitality are winning out in these fights. They're winning out in the team fights, Ender.
It's a critical fight to win. Their Vitality looking to play spoiler against Misfits. If Misfits lose this game, their playoff hopes will be dashed. They will not have a chance of making it into ever since introducing Crownshot onto the roster. And now he's the one with 4 kills. Yesterday it was Cobby with a triple kill on the Tristana in the bot room to completely end the game. And now it's Crownshot going hard.
Just trying to demolish Zoe in the mid lane. Featherstorm used. VTO didn't burn his flash, didn't burn his ignite. Crownshot will get the Rift Herald charge in here. The tower goes down. LeBrov trying to hex flash forward, but can't quite land it. Sleep's going to connect, though, and Razzok forced away. Shigenda beating out Hirit once again in the side lane. This Sion can be very tanky, but right now he can't even win in the 1v1. He's going to get chased under the tower, but there's the Unstoppable Onslaught. Shigenda has the flash to try and get away, but the Decimating Smash will not be enough. Unstoppable Shadows used in the end as Razzle cleans up the kill.
The Shigenda feeling himself a little bit too much in the bot lane. Vander Razzle playing Disruption into the back line because he is the player that will completely destroy Misfits come these 5v5s. kite away from Misfits.
Okay, they know Militza isn't here. He does have the TP to join the fight. Paddle Star goes wide. There's double turbo chem tanks on the side of Misfits. If they look for the engage, perhaps they can catch out Vitality before Vitality have a chance to answer. Hirit has the Predator now on the sign as well. TP coming in. Militza's going to join the fray. Shigenda going in. Look for the Gnar, but the Magnus Storm's going to stop them. On the backline, VTO has been
crowd shot.
The Feather Storm has crowd shot just about.
He's alive!
Uses the Gale Force. Uses every tool at his disposal to get out. VTO's dead. Vander's dead. And perhaps Misfits' hopes of making playoffs have gone to the grave with them. Vitality pushing mid.
Misfits threw everything they could at crowd shot, and crowd shot said, not today. He survives. Vitality take yet another team fight, delete VTO and Vander from the Rift, and they will claim the second Infernal Drake for themselves. Misfits have yet to find an angle that works for them come these team fights, but they have a 5-minute window.
Misfits playoff hopes on the line, and they have to get through this Xayah crown
shot. This is such a good fight for them, though. If they can get this corralled fight where all of Vitality are in one spot, they have to step into darkness, but if they can find the engage.
Yeah, but that's the problem. Militza's in the fog of war from the top side. Labrov down underneath, and I'm not sure they're going to scout this one out.
Crown shot has no summons, but Vander's already caught and suppressed. It's all on Cobby and VTO to do what they can. Vazal going in with the Onslaught of Shadows. Crown shot locked up, but there's just no follow up. There's just no damage, and Himid on the back line will be taken. And out Vitality are going to ace Misfits, and I'm sorry, but the bunnies are dead.
Vitality show up. It's a bee's knees kind of day. Taking that fight flawlessly. 5 kills for none. Crown shot, 3 items, absolutely tearing through. Vitality now with a massive advantage. 10,000 gold here, sieging down on these inner turrets. And Misfits, they have pretty much one direction they can go. It is in these fights.
Vander has the flash. Are you going to go in?
Look at the cannon minions just beating down on this turret. VTO can't step forward. He's concerned about himself, so he can't actually use his range to clear away those waves. Both inhibitor towers fall in mid and bot at the same time. Misfits still don't think they can fight. They're going to sack their inhibitors, hope that Vitality can't end the game and gain access to all the gold, the minions flooding into their base, but it is looking so, so dire for the Misfits.
Just have to look back at what we said after draft. Misfits got everything they wanted here, and with 4 cannons and a Bannon and 5 members of Vitality, Misfits are on their last legs. One Nexus Tower stands between them and being eliminated, and the Root comes out. Militza dives in, Crown Shot goes legendary, and the Wombo is the combo.
They kill Crown Shot.
Crown Shot. Cobby has to survive, but he's suppressed, pulled back into the meat grinder. That is Vitality. Cobby is dead. Misfits are dead, and Vitality have killed off any hopes the Rabbits had of making playoffs. Say thank you to Vitality, SK, and Fnatic, because they have secured you your spot in the final 6.
The final weekend of the LEC has been absolutely ridiculous. Vitality come in and deliver yet another upset to break the hearts of Misfits fans around Europe. And oh my word, Crown Shot coming into this team. This team, remind you, completely turned it around in the second half of the season. Got big wins against teams like Fnatic, critically to